This is a 3D printed fishing rod. And reel. And bubbles. And other things. The channel recently got a 3D printer, and I immediately had a whole bunch of crazy ideas, but I needed to test and see what 3D printers are actually capable of. I found this file on MakerWorld. It's just a 3D printed fishing rod. Comes with a reel that looks kind of like this. And that's okay, but there's really no like break system. So if you catch a fish, it's gonna try to rip out of your hands. And so I found this one also on MakerWorld, different designer, and it does some cool stuff. So we're gonna put this one together. We're gonna throw it on the rod and then we're gonna go test it out. We're gonna see, when does this thing break? This is the original file, by the way. Obviously a tiny cute little thing, but this is not gonna survive. Okay, where does it break? Oh, yeah, see? So I increased the size, the number of wall loops, and then I also increased the infill density and changed it to a gyroid. Now these do just slide in like this together. The creator obviously took into account that you're going to want to disassemble and reassemble this thing, so. This is a 3D printed fishing rod. Where do you think it's gonna break? Put your guess down below. Now, the only problem I have is I don't have my fishing license, so I need somebody who can help me test the dang thing. We'll see. All right, I got Kale here helping me out.
Yes, sir.
He's gonna test it for me because I don't wanna get in trouble.
Yeah.
So theoretically, all you have to do is take this off of here.
Oh.
And it should just fly.
All right.
That's out there.
It's out there.
That counts. All right, it's time to break this thing. I'm gonna attach one end to my car. My car is gonna act as our fish here, and the other end is gonna get stuck over there somewhere. And we're gonna drive until it breaks. We'll see what happens. I just really need to see what breaks first. If it's the reel itself, if it's one of these components holding it on, if it's one of these rings, or if it's the pole itself. I wanna see which part breaks so that I can kind of determine where my failure point is for future builds that I wanna do. Ha! That'll do, pig, that'll do. Okay, I just gotta wedge this in here really good. And so, whoa, that's how strong it is. Ah, there you go. Wow, check that out. That's our fracture point. That's a thick piece though to break. I figured it would be one of the smaller ones. Huh, wild.
Well, string didn't break, but the pole did.
Woo! That was a weird break. All right, we got it to break. Holy cow, that was crazy. I expected one of these thinner parts to break first. They just didn't do it. They didn't break first. It was this piece. You can see it cracked apart there. So here's what I learned from the test. It seems as though, as long as you have some kind of exterior framework around your joint, you're gonna be super secure and strong. In instances where you can't do something like that, another option is gonna have to be strengthening the sidewalls. And if you're trying to keep it light, my guess, and I'm not an expert, this is my intuition based on what I saw in this test. Thicker sidewall, little bit thinner infill overall if we're going for the same weight in order to have that strength. Now, I'm sure that depends on the type of material. The layer adhesion is gonna be very different between, you know, TPU and PLA, for example, or ABS. Having that layer adhesion on different materials is gonna make that break differently. In this case, it broke basically on a layer line, kinda. Well, it prints this way, so I don't know, that's weird. But it definitely broke where there's a thinner sidewall right there at the top, where like the base of the print is. And that makes sense, right? Number one, because that's where the majority of the strength is being pulled from. When you're bending it like this, this is gonna see a lot more stress than this. I feel like this just tore away because surface was too thin in terms of the wall. Good stuff. TPU transparent, it's pretty flexible in this instance. And does a good job. If you like videos like this, consider subscribing. I've got more plans on the way. Wasn't me.